money, and this should be quite a matchup. His opponent there, certainly a longtime favorite in the World Wrestling Federation from New Zealand, at 241 pounds, Tony Garea. Very interesting matchup here. It's a pick'em type of a match. There's no telling, rather, who will win. We're just about ready for the action to begin. David, if you had to pick a victor here in this match, who would it be? Would it be Tony Garea or Johnny Rods?
Well, right now you're looking at two wrestlers at any given time can beat any wrestler in professional wrestling. They both have tremendous ability. They're both in tremendous condition. And it would be very hard to pick a winner in this match. Tony Garea, very scientific wrestler. Johnny Rods, a little rougher, which I prefer to do. He takes advantage of every situation. So that, to me, gives him a little bit of the edge. But like I said, either one of these men are capable of beating anybody on any given day.
Garea with a nice takedown. Not too many wrestlers hail from the country of New Zealand. Tony Garea, wearing his country's colors very proudly. Have you ever toured in all of your worldwide wrestling? Have you ever toured to the country of New Zealand?
Yes, I have. It's a nice place for farmers. They got a lot of cows and a lot of sheep. Not my type of place, I like that sort of thing. Well, that's fine. But like I said, it's fine for farmers. Now you can see where Johnny Rods is getting the advantage.
You can also see Johnny Rods doing more than adjusting. That's the corner unprotected now. Rods off the rope. You'll see Johnny Rods using the ropes to his advantage on many occasions. And Tony Garea doesn't know it. It looks like he's headed right for the unprotected corner. No, nice block. Rods down into it.
He hit that awful hard. There's no turnbuckle in that corner.
That steel ring striking the forehead of Rods, and Johnny Rods now from pillar to post. Oh, nice maneuver by Tony Garea. Cover by Garea gets two, and that's all.
That started to be a very good move by Johnny Rods, but I would have done that a little different.
Now, how would you have done it differently?
Well, I wouldn't have got my head run into that bare piece of steel there that Tony Garea just run his head into. I'd have been a little more cautious about it.
Johnny Rods with a right hand just clipped Tony Garea. Now with a knee into the back into the throat. Tony Garea in a lot of trouble.
Both of these guys can take it. They can take it as well as anybody. Both of them very impressive wrestlers.
Johnny Rods to the corner now. Ooh, right down onto Tony Garea.
Taking good advantage of those ropes. Those ropes are a big help if you know how to use them right.
Referee cautioning Johnny Rods now. I would think it's somewhat of an art on the part of Johnny Rods or maybe a crippler, Ray Stevens, to know just how far you can push a referee in terms of bending the rules before you're disqualified and thus lose the match.
Absolutely it is. You got to know just how to do it, or you will be disqualified. You'll be fined a lot of money. And when I step in the ring, I go in there to win, and the only way you make money is to be a winner.
Tony Garea being set up by Johnny Rods now. Missing with the elbow, right back, flying body press by Tony Garea. Doesn't get him. Did not hook the leg. Ooh, look at that. Clipped him right across the jaw.
Good move on Rod's part. You could see the power when he threw Garea off. Back body.
No, sunset flip. Will he get him down? Johnny rods over as he legs. No. Couldn't quite hook him properly.
A lot of times, you know, it looks like a fellow should be pinned, but you take one of these big men, and when you grab him, you better have him just right, or you're not going to hold him there. Now, you see, if Rods was doing this right, he would be taking the air right out of his throat right now, without the referee.
I would suspect that's exactly what he is doing. That's a chokehold, is it not?
Not quite. He has it on the side. I'm sure he's making Gurria a little weak because the blood's slowing down going to his head right now.
Johnny Rods now bringing Tony Gurria, trying to get him over.
Trying to get him set for a suplex.
Look at that. Nicely done by Gurria. Very nicely done.
That's what I mean. Either one of these men are capable of beating anybody on any given day.
I'm sure that includes Ray Stevens.
On the right day, maybe I was sick.
If you were sick?
Yes.
Johnny Rods with a kick. Now, this is nip and tuck. Seesaw battle pretty much all the way. Nice reversal by Tony Gurria. Trying to set up the back body drop, but kick to the chest. It was a telegraph maneuver. Rods with the momentum. Reversal by Gurria, however. And there is the way it's supposed to be done.
Good competition here. Good even competition.
Wide body press. Hooks the leg. Gets him. So Tony Gurria, 2 weeks in a row, victorious with the flying body press. Really looks good, Tony does.
I would have to say he was very lucky to get that pin on Johnny Rods.
And again, they're continuing to slug it out here. Drop kick into the chest. Momentum takes Rods all the way over and outside. He's hot. Tony Gurria gets the Duke. We'll take you back now to action we saw earlier on. Call it, Mr. Stevens. There, the back body drop.
Beautiful back drop by Gurria. I'm going to give credit where credit's due right here. And he took a lot of the sting out of Johnny Rods with that.
And look at that. Went way up high with that flying body press. Hooked the leg. Perfect pinning position. Rods kicks out. It's a little too late.